So 50th question, what they ask. The decay constant of a radioisotope is lambda. If A1 and A2 are its activities at the time T1 and T2 respectively. So the number of nuclei which have decayed during the time T1 minus of T2. So which options is the right answer we have to choose for this? So we know, so for 50th one, so read the question once, twice or thrice and try to understand the question. So then only we are possible to solve the or choose the right answer. So they have given four options here: A1 T1 minus of A2 T2, second one A1 minus of A2, third one A1 minus of A2 divided by lambda, and fourth one they have given lambda in the bracket A1 minus of A2. So they have given four options and we have to choose the right answer. So for 50th one, so how we are going to solve? Let us see this one. So here, let us, we are considering A1 is equal to lambda into N1 at the time T1. So at a time T1 it is. And same thing, A2 is equal to lambda into N2. This is at a time T2. So therefore, number of nuclei decay during the time interval T1 minus of T2, we have to calculate. So therefore, N1 minus of N2 is equal to A1 minus of A2 divided by lambda. So therefore, according to this, if you observe the options, so for 50th one, the right answer is C1. That is A1 minus of A2 divided by lambda. What this one? Next, 51. In the nuclear decay given below, so one kind of reaction they have given, the particles emitted in the sequence are, so they have given one reaction. So in that, the particles emitted in the sequences we have to find, and they have given four options. So from the given reaction, so this is the given reaction they have given. So first, X decay by beta emission emitting gamma antineutrino. Simultaneously, Y emits alpha, resulting in the excited level of B, which in turn emits gamma rays. Therefore, beta, alpha and gamma is the answer. So that is among four options, that is right answer is beta, alpha and gamma. So here, X decay by beta emission, they have given X here. And same thing, emitting gamma antineutrino simultaneously, and Y they have given. So Y emits alpha, resulting in excited level of B, which in terms of gamma rays. Therefore, for 50th one, the right answer is D1. Next, 52th one. The number of beta particles emitted by radioactive substance is twice the number of alpha particles emitted by it. Resulting daughter is an isomer of parent, isotone of parent, isotope of parent, isobar of parent. So they have given four options for 52th one. So the resulting daughter is an isotope of the original parent nucleus. So therefore, that is this option is the right answer. So this one, if you go through the properties of alpha, beta and gamma, so some reactions are coming across. If you go through that, definitely you can possible to solve like this kind of questions. Next, 53rd one, two radioactive materials, that is X1 and X2, have decay constants 5 lambda and lambda respectively. If initial they have same number of nuclei, then the ratio of the number of nuclei X1 and X2 will be 1 by E after the time. And they have given 4 options, and among 4 options we have to choose the right answer. So for 53rd one, so let us consider X1 is equal to N0 e to the power of minus lambda 1 into T, and X2 is equal to N0 e to the power of minus lambda 2 into T. So we are taking the ratio X1 by AX2 is equal to e to the power of minus lambda 1 plus of lambda 2 into T. So if you simplify this one, it become e to the power of minus 1 is equal to e to the power of minus lambda 1 minus of lambda 2 into T. So we want to calculate T value. Therefore, modulus of 1 by lambda 1 means we are taking that one in the denominator. So this becomes 1 divided by lambda 1 value is 5 lambda and lambda 2 value is lambda itself. So if you simplify this one, 5 lambda minus of lambda, it becomes 4 lambda. So therefore, for 53rd one, the right answer is 8th one, that is 1 divided by 4 lambda. Next, 54th one. Two radioactive substances A and B have decay constants so 54th one. Two radioactive substances A and B have decay constants 5 lambda and lambda respectively. So it looks like similar as before one, but it is a bit different. At T is equal to 0, they have same number of nuclei. The ratio of number of nuclei of A to the B will be 1 by E to the power of E square after the time interval. And they have given 4 options. So this one for 54th one, we are going to solve like this. For 54th one, so lambda A is equal to 5 lambda in the question itself they have given. And lambda B is equal to lambda. This is at T is equal to 0. Means N0 A is equal to N0 into B. So at any time T, so NA divided by NB is equal to 1 by E whole to the power of square. So according to decay law, radioactive decay law, so we are having formula N divided by N0 is equal to E to the power of lambda into T. So according to this, NA divided by N0 is equal to E to the power of minus lambda A to the power of T becomes. So therefore, same thing, NB divided by N0 into B is equal to E to the power of minus lambda B into T. So let us consider this one as equation 2 and this is as equation 1. Next, dividing equation 1 divided by 2. So then it becomes NA divided by NB is equal to E to the power of minus lambda A minus of lambda B into T. So, or you can represent this one as Na divided by Nb is equal to V to the power of minus 5 lambda minus of lambda into T. Or you can represent this one as 1 by E whole square is equal to E to the power of minus 4 lambda into T. Or 1 by E whole square is equal to 1 by E to the power of 4 lambda into T. So 4 lambda into T is equal to 2. Therefore, T value we are getting 1 by 2 lambda. So therefore, according to this one, for 54th one, the right answer is fifth one. Next, 55th one. In the radio decay process, the negative charged emitted beta particles are. So they have given four options, go through it. And in beta minus decay, a neutron is transformed into a proton and electron is emitted with the nucleus along with an antineutrino. Therefore, for 55th one, the right answer is electron produced as a result of a decay neutron inside the nucleus is the right answer. Next, 56th one. In a radioactive material, the activity at time T1 is R1, and later time T2, it is R2. The decay constant of the material is lambda. Then, which one is the suitable answer we have to choose? So for 56th one, according to decay law, so we know the formula R is equal to R0 e to the power of lambda into T. So therefore, R1 is equal to R0 e to the power of minus lambda into T1. Same thing, R2 is equal to R0 e to the power of lambda T2. So we are taking the ratio R1 by R2 is equal to R0 e to the power of lambda T1 divided by R0 e to the power of minus lambda into T2. So this becomes e to the power of lambda T1 into e to the power of lambda T2. So take the common term. So it becomes T1 minus of T2. Or you can represent this one as R1 is equal to R2 e to the power of minus lambda in the bracket T1 minus of T2. So for 56th one, the right answer is B one. So I hope you are getting. Only if you go through theory concept, then only it is possible to understand. 57th one, in the reaction, they have given one reaction. This is the reaction they have given. The binding energy of H12, H13, helium 24 are respectively ABC in mega electron volt. Then the energy released in this reaction is. So which one is suitable answer we have to choose for this? So energy released E is equal to, that is equivalent to energy equivalent of mass defection delta M. So that is almost equal to delta M. So we know delta M is equal to mass of product minus of mass of reactant. We are having the formula. So according to this, so E is equal to energy C minus of A minus of B we are writing. Therefore, for 57th one, C one is the right answer. The half life of radium is about 1600 years. If 100 gram of radium existing now, 25 gram will remain unchanged after they have asking the time here. So this one we are going to calculate for 58th one. So using the formula n is equal to n naught in the bracket 1 by 2 whole to the power of n. So that is equal to n divided by n naught is equal to 1 by 2 whole to the power of n. So according to this, 25 divided by 100 is equal to 1 by 2 to the power of n. Therefore, n value is equal to 2. So total time in which radium charge to 25 gram is, total time in which radium change to 25 gram is, that is equal to 2 into 1600, that is equal to 3200 years. Therefore, for 58 one, the right answer is 1. Next, 59th one. A sample of radioactive element has a mass of 10 gram at an instant t is equal to 0. The approximate mass of this element in the sample after 2 mean mu is. They have given 1.35 grams, 2.50, 3.70 and 6.30 grams. They have given. So this one we are going to calculate for 59th. So for 59th one, at a time t is equal to 0, m naught is equal to 10 grams. And at t is equal to 2E, so that is 2 into 1 by lambda. So therefore, m is equal to m naught e to the power of minus lambda into t is equal to 10 e to the power of lambda into 2 by lambda is equal to 10 in the bracket 1 by e whole square. This value we are getting 1.35 gram. Therefore, for 59th one, eighth one is the right answer. 60th one, a nuclear reaction is given by, they have given one reaction, and which one it is we have to find, whether it is a beta decay, gamma decay, fusion process or fission process. By seeing the equation, we have to identify the right answer. So here, by seeing the nuclear reaction, the given reaction is a beta decay process. Therefore, eighth one is the right answer. 61, a sample of radioactive element contains 4 into 10 to the power of 16 active nuclei. Half-life of element is 10 days. Then new number of decayed nuclei after 30 days is. So here, number of initial active for 61 we are solving. So from the question what they have given, number of initial active nuclei they have given, that is 4 into 10 to the power of 16. So number of decayed nuclei after 10 days we have to calculate. After 10 days, nothing but half life, that is equal to 4 into 10 to the power of 16 divided by 2 is equal to 2 ones are 2 twos are. So 2 into 10 to the power of 16 we are getting. So remaining number of nuclei after 10 days, that is equal to 4 into 10 to the power of 16 minus of 2 into 10 to the power of 16. The result we are getting 2 into 10 to the power of 16 itself. Number of decayed nuclei in next 10 days, that is calculated by using 2 into 10 to the power of 16 divided by 2 is equal to 2 ones are, we are getting that one has 1 into 10 to the power of 16. Similarly, number of decayed nuclei in next 10 days. So that is, similarly in next 10 days, that we are having 0.5 into 10 to the power of 16, because half of 1 is 0.5. Total number of nuclei decayed after 30 days. So that is 2 into 10 to the power of 16 plus of 1 into 10 to the power of 16 plus of 0.5 into 10 to the power of 16 is equal to 3.5 into 10 to the power of 16 we are having. Therefore, for 61th one, so the right answer is C one. 62th one. A deuteron is bombarded on oxygen nucleus, then alpha particle is emitted. The product nucleus is. So the nuclear reaction, from the nuclear reaction, so we are writing this nuclear reaction like this. So oxygen 8-16 plus of hydrogen 1-2 undergoes, it is going to produce nitrogen 7-14 plus of helium 2-4. So when a deuterium is bombarded on oxygen nucleus, then alpha particle is emitted. The product nucleus is nitrogen. Therefore, the right answer is this one. Next, 63rd one. Which rays contain positively charged particles? Alpha, beta rays, gamma rays, and X rays they have given. So for 63rd one, alpha rays are the positively charged particles. Therefore, the right answer, which one is the right answer? For 63rd one, 8th one is the right answer. Next, 64th one, Xn, alpha, lithium, they have given, then X will be. So for 64th one, if you write the reaction, it becomes boron 5-10 plus of. So the reaction we are writing like this, plus of lithium 3-7. So for 64th one, if you write the reaction, so we are getting like this reaction, from this reaction, so we are getting the right answer, that is boron 5-10 we are getting. Next, 65th one, half-life of radioactive element is 12.5 hours and its quantity is 256 grams. After how much time its quantity will remain 1 gram they have given. So it is calculated by using formula N by N naught is equal to 1 by 2 whole to the power of N. So N means number of decay it represents. So therefore, 1 divided by 256 is equal to 1 divided by 2 to the power of 8 and the baribodu. So this one 1 by 2 whole to the power of N, therefore N value is 8. So time for 8 half life is, we are getting that one as 100 hours. Therefore, this one is the right answer. Next, 66th one. For the given reaction, the particles X is, one reaction they have given, X N represent participants here, neutron, neutrino, antineutrino, and proton. This one is the right answer, that is neutrino. Next, 67th one. A reaction of Bardaga next N percent Gotra Matra, 66th one easy again. Find out Marbodu. 67th one. The relation between lambda and T half is direct question is Edu. So T half formula. So that is T half is equal to lambda 2 divided by lambda. This is direct formula. So next, 68th one. Alpha particles are okay, neutrally charged or positron, proton, ionized helium atoms on the kildara. So alpha particles are ionized helium atoms. The right answer is this one. Next, 69th one. After 1 alpha and 2 beta emission, so here they have given mass number reduced by 6, mass number reduced by 4, mass number reduced by 2. Atomic number remains unchanged and kottidara. Illi erdu options aagtava, B nu aagbodu, D nu aagbodu. So I alpha reduce the mass number by 4 units and atomic number by 2 units, while 1 beta only increases the atomic number by 1 unit. Therefore, for 69th one, B matha D, erdu option aagtava. Akkaita, mass number tagondre B aagutte, atomic number anta tagondre D anta aagutte. So both are possible. So everyone getting? Seventieth one. Complete the equation for the following. Note fusion matha fission process difference hodidre idanu kuda touch maadabodu. Complete the equation for the following fission process anta ondu reaction kotra, but adu incomplete aithi. Aa mundu baruvanta product yavud aithi anta find out maadbeku. Examples anna new ena adana observe maadidre easy a find out maadabodu. For 70th one, the right answer is C1. A reaction complete maadbeku. Example olaga reaction nodkondidre you can easily guess that answer. So 71. So for 71, half life of two radioactive substances A and B are 20 minutes and 40 minutes. Initially, sample A and B have equal number of nuclei. After 18 minutes, the ratio of remaining number A and B nucleus A nagutte anta kelidara. So for 71, nodri. For A iddaga 80 minutes itta. ಅವಾಗ ಫೋರ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಅಂತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಆಗ್ತಾವ? ಎನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 16. ಅದೇ ಫಾರ್ ಬಿಗೆ 80 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಅದರದ್ದು ಟೂ ಹಾಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಆಗುತ್ತ. ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಆಗ್ತಾವ ಬಿಗೆ? ಎನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬೈ 4 ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವುದು? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ 1:4 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ 71:181 ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. Next, 72th one. The most penetrating radiation. Yaudu? Beta rays, X-rays, gamma rays or alpha rays. This is the answer. Properties mele aithi. So, gamma rays are the most penetrating radiation. Therefore, beta is the right answer. 73rd one. What is the respective number of alpha and beta particles emitted in the following radioactive DK ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಇಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಫೋರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ಆನ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಒನ್ ಅಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಅಟೋಮಿಕ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಬೈ 2 ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಾಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಬೈ 4 ಯೂನಿಟ್ ವೈಲ್ ದ ಎಮಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೀಟಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಮಾಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಟೋಮಿಕ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಬೈ 1 ಯೂನಿಟ್. So decrease in mass number that is given by 200 minus of 168 is equal to 32. We are getting number of alpha particles just 2, that is 32 divided by 4 and the 8 varata. Number of beta particles that is 16 minus of 10, we are getting that one as 6. Therefore B one is the right answer. 8 must be 6 and varata. Right answer is B one. Next, 74th one. The binding energy per nucleon for a deuterium and alpha particles are x1 and x2 respectively. Energy released in the reaction is, and they have given one reaction. Just observe that reaction. So from that reaction, number of nucleons and the reactant side astadava idu reactant sorry idu productant idu reactant side so number of nucleons on reactant side astadava 4 adu binding energy of the nucleon anna x1 antagondre for 4 nucleons ge est agutta 4 times of x1 agutte similarly product side ge ile 4x2 antagondi product anta so now q annode enadu idinna find out maarbekalva so q andra charge in binding energy adu find out maarbekandra 4 in the bracket x2 minus of x1 anta tagotivi therefore b1 is the right answer 75th one the count rate of Krieger Muller counter for the radiation of radioactive material of half life of 30 minutes decreases to 5 seconds after 2 hours initial count rate was yes it's 8 seconds 80 seconds 20 seconds 625 seconds and 25 seconds anta kottidaru so half life andre 30 minutes रेट आफ डिक्रीज अंसर मोदी 5 पर् सेकेंड एंड टोटल टाइम अंदर 2 अवर्स अंदर 120 मिनट्स आगुत्ते सो रिलेशन फॉर इनिशियल एंड फाइनल काउंटर रेट दैट इज गिवन बाय बाय द फॉर्मूला फॉर 76 वन वी आर डूइंग आर बाय आर नॉट इज इक्वल टू हाफ लाइफ 1/2 टाइम डिवाइडेड बाय हाफ लाइफ इधर प्रकार 1/2 होल टू द पावर ऑफ 120 डिवाइडेड बाय 30 1/2 होल टू द पावर ऑफ 4 आगुत्ते अदन्ना 1/16 अंत बरीबहुदा देयरफॉर आर नॉट इज इक्वल टू 16 × r 16 × r वैल्यू एष्टु 5 अंदर 80 सेकंड्स अंत बरुत्ते देयरफॉर फॉर 75th वन 8th वन इज द राइट आंसर Next 76th one the mass of alpha particle is 4 option they have given less than sum of mass of 2 protons and 2 neutrons equal to mass of 4 protons equal to mass of 4 neutrons equal to sum of masses of 2 protons and 2 neutrons anta kottidara so alpha particles ge andre ena example baribodu helium 2 4 so it contains 2 protons or 2 neutrons irtava therefore 8th one is the right answer so that is less than the sum of mass of 2 protons and 2 neutrons next 77th one half life of radium is 1600 years the fraction of a sample of radium that remains after 6400 years so for 77th one n by n naught is equal to 1/2 to the power of 6400 divided by 1600 yadi so this become 1/2 whole to the power of 4 andra 1/16 of the calculate madabodu therefore d one is the right answer Next 78th one the nucleus carbon absorbs an energetic neutron and emits a beta particle resulting nucleus yav barutha ant kelidara so neevu idak reaction heng baribodu for 78th one ge en barithiri carbon 612 plus of Positron undergoes carbon 613 undergoes nitrogen 713 plus of beta minus of 10 plus of energy. So therefore, B one is the right answer. Reaction barda gota gatte. So next 79th one. A radioactive element has half life period of 800 years after 6400 years what amount will remain anta kelidara is in the same yeah formula, number of half life n is equal to small t divided by capital T is equal to 6400 divided by 800 madidra 2020 cancel aagi 8 participate madide and n by n naught is equal to 1 to the power of half to the power of 8 madidre eshtu barutha 1 by 256 ant barutha answer therefore the right answer is 1 divided by 256 D one is the right answer. Next, 81. An element DK into element C by two steps process. Next, remaining question. It is on right hand side. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಎ ಅಂಡರ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೀಲಿಯಂ ಬಿ ಅಂಡರ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಸಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಇಂಟು ಇ ಮೈನಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಫೋರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾರೆ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಐಸೋಟೋಸ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಐಸೋಬೋರ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿ ಆರ್ ಐಸೋಟೋಸ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿ ಆರ್ ಐಸೋಬಾರ್ ಯಾವ್ದು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಚೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದಾರ ಸೊ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಟೂ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೂ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ ದ ಸಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಒನ್ A lot of two units of charge by emission of alpha particles. Therefore, option yav dagutha A and C are the isotopes as their charge number is the same. Therefore, for 81 is the right answer. Next, 81. Curie is a unit of energy of gamma rays, half life, radioactivity, intensity of gamma rays. So they have given four options. So the Curie is the unit of radioactivity. Therefore, this one is the right answer. 82th one. A radioactive sample with half life of 1 month has a label activity 2 microcuries on 1-8-1991, what would be the activity 2 months earlier? So 82th one, in 2 half-lives, activity become 1/4 active. Activity on 1-8-91, 2 microcuries. Therefore, activity before 2 months, andra, hang madthidina, 4 into 2 microcuries, andra, 8 microcuries paratha. Therefore, D1 is the right answer. 83rd one. The nucleus cadmium after 2 successive beta decay will give. And they have given 4 options. So, 2 successive beta decay increases the charge number by 2. So, therefore, for 83rd one, D1 is the right answer. Next, 84th one. So, next, the coming question is based on nuclear energy. So, 84th one. When a uranium isotope is bombarded with neutron, it generates krypton, 3 neutrons, ion. What will be the next result they are asking? So if you write this reaction, it becomes uranium-235. Plus of bombarded with neutrino, it undergoes or it is going to produce krypton plus 3 neutrino and it is going to produce XZA. So here sum this 92 plus of 0 is equal to 36 plus of Z means reactant is equal to productant we are doing. By using that one, we are going to find Z value. So Z value is 56. So now, 235 plus of 1, that is equal to 89 plus of 3 plus of A. Therefore, A value we are getting that one as 144. So, for beryllium is generated. That is, for 84th one, 8th one is the right answer. Because A value is 144, that is already mentioned here. Next, 85th one. A certain mass of hydrogen is changed to helium by process of fusion. The mass effect in fusion reactant is 0.02866 atomic mass unit. Energy liberated per unit is, and one atomic mass unit they have given in the question itself. So here, if you write the reaction for this, it becomes like this. Hydrogen 1,2 plus of hydrogen 1,2. If it undergoes, it is going to produce helium 2,4. So here, delta M value is 0.02866 atomic mass unit. Energy liberated, we have to calculate, that is delta M into 931 divided by 4. So according to this one, 0.02866 into 931 divided by 4 is equal to 26.7 divided by 4. If you simplify this one, we are getting 6.67 mega electron volt. Therefore, 8th one is the right answer. Next, 86th one. The power obtained in a reactor using uranium-235 disintegration is 1000 kilowatts. The mass decay of uranium-235 per hour is. So according to Anderson mass energy relation, so we are using E is equal to mc square, and mass we have to calculate, modify the formula E divided by c square. So mass decay per second is calculated by using formula delta N divided by delta T. So that's equal to P divided by C square. Or substitute the values, known values. That is, P value is 1000 into 10 to the power of 3 watts, and velocity of light is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second square. So if you simplify this one, we are getting 10 to the power of 6, 9 into 10 to the power of 16. Mass per decay per hour we have to calculate, delta M divided by delta T into 60 into 60. So if you are doing like this one, so we are getting this one as 40 microgram. Therefore, for 86th one, C one is the right answer. Next, 87th one. Fusion reaction takes place at high temperature because exactly at high temperature needed for fusion makes kinetic energy large enough to overcome Coulomb repulsion between nuclei. Therefore, for 87th one, C one is the right answer. Next, 88th one. The binding energy per nucleon in deuterium and helium nuclei are 1.1 mega electron volt and 7 mega electron volt. When two deuterium nuclei fuses to form a helium nucleus, energy released in the fusion is. So here, the binding energy, so or we can possible to write the reaction here. So for 88th one, so hydrogen 1,2 plus of hydrogen 1,2, it undergoes reaction to form helium plus of energy. So binding energy per nucleon of deuterium is 1.1 mega electron volt. Total binding energy is 2 into 1.1 is equal to 2.2 mega electron volt. So same thing, total binding energy per nucleon of helium is 7 mega electron volts. Total binding energy is 4 into 7 is equal to 28 mega electron volts. So hence, energy released is calculated by using delta E is equal to 28 minus of 2 into 2.2. So this one we are getting 23.6 mega electron volt. Therefore, 81 is the right answer. Next, 89th one. The binding energy of deuterium is 2.2 mega electron volt and that of helium is 28 mega electron volt. If two deuterons are fused to form a helium, then energy released, how much they are asking for 89th one? The right answer, you can easily guess this one. Can you guess this one? For 89th one, this one is the right answer, that is 23.6 mega electron volt. For 90th one, in any fission process, the ratio of mass of fission product divided by mass of parent nucleus, that is always equal to less than 1. Therefore, right answer is this one. 91. If in a nuclear fission process, the mass of fusion nuclei is M1 and M2, mass of resultant nuclei will be M3. Then in the fusion, mass of end product or resultant is always less than the sum of initial product. The rest is liberated in the form of energy, like in sun is liberated during fusion of two hydrogen atoms. Therefore, this one is the right answer for 91. Next, 92. Solar energy is mainly caused due to. So, which is the right answer? So they have given 4 options. The right answer for 92th one is C one is the right answer. For 92th one, C one is the right answer. Easy neither. 93, nuclear fission is best explained by liquid drop theory. Therefore, 8th one is the right answer. Which of the following is used as a moderator in the nuclear reactor? So in the nuclear fission, chain reaction is controlled in such a way that only one neutron produced in each fission causes further fission. Therefore, some moderator is used to slow down the neutrons. Heavy water is used for this purpose. Therefore, this one is the right answer. 95th one, energy released in the fission of single uranium nucleus is 200 mega electron volts. The fusion rate of uranium filled reactor operating at a power level of 5 watts. So this is fission rate is calculated by using formula total power divided by energy whole divided by fission. So that's equal to 5 divided by 200 into 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 13. We are getting that one as 1.56 into 10 to the power of 11 per second. Therefore, this one is the right answer. 96th one, solar energy is due to. First option, fission reaction. Second one, first option fusion reaction, second one fission reaction, third one combustion reaction, fourth one chemical reaction. So is it a guess madabodha neevu? Okay, eighth one is the right answer. So whatever we discuss based on this, if you are having any doubt, just put in the chat box. Having any doubt? Whatever we discuss, based on this, if you are having any doubt, just put in the chat box. So if you are having no doubts, means we'll end up the session. Thank you.